from tonight. Joy.
Ayo.
The joy of salvation.
Ayo igbada.
The joy of redemption.
Ayo irapada.
The joy of forgiveness.
Ayo idariji.
The joy of a new life.
Ayo ibi aye otun.
The promise of salvation for your soul.
Ileri igbala fun okan re.
Your life will not stop there.
Ayo re okun ni pari ti beyen o.
Even if we stop there.
Ta ba ti edo mere
nikan. Salvation.
Igbala.
Salvation.
Igbala.
That's wonderful.
Iyanu leleyi.
But we are not going to stop there.
So bebe ko lati duro.
Until I lead you to number 3.
Titi ma bi mu lo si koko keta.
Power will come from heaven.
Agbara yo so kale latorun.
Enter your heart.
A wonu okan re.
Enter your family.
A wonu ebi re.
I will be searching.
Ask my wa.
Where is sickness?
Nibo la isan wa.
Sickness will flee away.
Isan yo gbagere.
Where is satanic attack?
Nibo ni daroro
satanic attack will vanish away.
Daroro satan yo gbagere.
Number 3.
Iketa.
The power of supernatural healing for the sick.
Agbara iwosan to gaju teda lo fun awon alaisan.
The power of supernatural healing for the sick. I'm rejoicing with you already. I see what is going to happen to you. I see the power of God coming your way. Number 1, the problem. Number 2, the promise. Number 3, tell me. If it's going to be by your side there, I said number 3, what is it? The power. The power of supernatural healing for the sick.
And
let's take a look at number 1. The problem of sin and suffering. Here the prophet is telling us. He said, yes, a promise is coming your way.
But
what's the root of your problem?
What's
the origin of your problem?
Why
is life like this? The problem of sin and suffering. Jeremiah chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 13. In Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 13. Only acknowledge thine iniquity. That thou wast transgressed against the Lord thy God. And has cut out thy ways to the strangers under every green tree. And ye have not obeyed the voice. My voice, says the Lord. He says, that's the genesis of the problem. Don't dodge. And don't say, I don't know about that.
He said,
acknowledge. Accept. And confess. And say, yes, I know the root of my problem.
It's
the problem of my sin.
It's
the problem of evil.
He tells
us in verse 25. Of that same chapter 3. He said, we lie down in our shame. Our confusion covers us. For we have sinned. They said, we're confused because of sin. We are oppressed because of sin. We're being destroyed because of sin. Poverty will not allow us to eat because of sin.
They
said, because we have sin.
Sin
against the Lord our God. We and our fathers. From our youth even until this day. And have not obeyed the voice of our God. He says that is the reason we're suffering. It says there's a connection between sin and suffering. If you say that the rain of blessing is not falling on your house.
So banodebukorosinolere.
If you say that suffering will not allow you to rest.
So bani idiajekosimi.
Sickness and oppression will not allow you to breathe.
I started that. Daroro kodiori mumi.
It says, don't you know why?
Oni o madieni.
God is a good God.
Olorun Olorun to dara.
God is a wonderful God.
Olorun iyanu ni.
It's not His will that anybody will suffer.
Ise fere pe kanikan yo diya.
We cause the suffering for ourselves. We attracted the suffering to ourselves. He says, acknowledge that. Don't just be saying, I'm praying. He says, know the origin of your problem. Then look at chapter 4, verse 18. Thy way and thy doings have procured these things unto thee.
He said,
this is thy wickedness. Because it is bitter. Because it reacheth unto thine heart.
He said,
the sin is even pinching you now in your heart. It's like your heart will fly out.
There
is fear there.
They
are frightened. And there are enemies that are pursuing your life. And he said, but why? He said, you procured this to yourself. You attracted all this to your life.
Then
look at chapter 4, verse 22. I must allow the prophet to talk to you directly. So that you don't say, okay, that is what Pastor so and so said. No, look at verse 22, chapter 4. My people is foolish. They have not known me. They are salty children. And it says they have not understanding. They are wise to do evil. But to do good, they have no knowledge. He said, their ways are crooked. They know how to steal. They know how to cheat. They know how to fight. They know how to oppress. They know how to attack. They know how to destroy other people. They're cunning and clever and crafty. And they can do evil. But to do right, to live good, and to live neat, that one they don't know. They know how to drink alcohol. And they know how to use whatever instrument to attack. They know how to kill. They don't know how to raise to life. They know how to defile. They don't know how to keep others clean. And he said, that's their problem. That's the reason why they're suffering. The problem of sin and suffering. Look at chapter 5. Jeremiah said, if you're not convinced yet, that all this problem is not in vain. It's not just a joke. It's not accidental. I wish I were born in America. I wish I were born in London. If I was born in China, maybe I will not be suffering. They say this is our country. They say Nigeria.
Nigeria.
Why was I born in this place? Because now it's because I'm in Nigeria. That's why I'm suffering.
Nigeria.
Look at chapter 5, verse 25. Your iniquities have turned away these sins, and your sins have withholding good things from you.
I said that you ti yi gbogbo won yi pada ati ese yin ti fa orere seyin kuro lodo yin.
It is not Nigeria that is your problem.
You say Nigeria ni wahala re.
And you are the problem of yourself.
Iwo gan ni wahala re.
Look at that verse again.
Tu ese lekan si
your iniquities.
I said that yin
have turned away.
O ti yi on gbogbo
all these good things from you.
Gbogbo orere kuro lodo re.
Your sins. Your evil, your wickedness, your violence, you're not been on the side of God. You separate yourself from the Creator. The one that can bless you. The one that can make your life good. That's why tonight you will come out of your problem. Somebody there. Out. I said out. You will come out of the problem of sin. And then God will drive suffering away from your life. I thought Ketu will say amen. Look at verse 26 here. Chapter 5, verse 26. For among my people I found wicked men. What does he mean among my people? So they go to church and they say they are my people. They are baptized in water. They say they are my people. They read the Bible. They say they are my people. Among my people are found wicked men. They lay wage as he that setteth snares and they set a trap. And they catch men.
Verse 27,
as a cage is full of pearls, so are their houses full of deceit. Their house is full of deceit. He said, that is our problem. I thank God tonight. Information is coming. Revelation is coming. That God has sent a promise. And he has said this problem will not continue. God is sending a promise to you tonight. And the power of the Almighty God will back that promise. They will set you free. I said they will set you free. Are you still waiting for the promise? I said, are you waiting for the promise? You see, if there is something that's a problem, it's when the promise comes together with the power. United together. Well, drive every problem out of your life. You come out of that problem of sin and suffering. Then the power of God will come upon you. Something good is happening to you tonight. You'll come out of darkness. I said you'll come out of darkness. You'll come to the light. You'll come out of the wickedness. You'll come to the goodness of God. You'll come out of evil. Come out of sin. Come out of transgression. Come out of iniquity. And you come out of the you're coming to the forgiveness of the Lord. It will happen to somebody there. Where is the person there? Goodness coming upon your life. Mercy coming upon your life. Forgiveness coming upon your life. The smile of heaven. The smile of heaven will come upon your life. You will go out. You will be free as a feather. Guilt will go. Condemnation will go. You say, praise the Lord, I am free. Number two, the promise of salvation for your soul. You know, the people, when Jeremiah came, they were suffering.
One day,
and when they saw Jeremiah, they said, Jeremiah, come.
When Jeremiah, wa.
Why are these things happening to us? Jeremiah chapter 8.
Jeremiah,
I'm reading from verse 20. Jeremiah chapter 8, verse 20.
Jeremiah,
harvest is past and summer is ended, and we are not saved. They said, we have been waiting for the salvation of the Lord. Thank God the harvest for you has not ended. Thank God summer for you has not ended. The time of forgiveness has not ended for you. The time of joy has not ended for you. As they were asking, He
was a bere.
And he was saying,
he was a wipe.
The harvest has passed. The summer is ended. And we are not saved. For the hurt of the daughter of my people and my hurt. I am black and astonishment has taken hold on me. Is there no panic? Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then is not the heart of my people, the health of the daughter of my people, recovered? I'm saying God is here tonight. And God is going to wash you. And God is going to cleanse you. But there'll be a prayer that comes out of your mouth. Already said, call unto me. Call unto me. But you didn't, he's not going to allow to just say, it's okay, I'm praying. He will tell you how to pray. When God tells you how to pray, and he says, tell me this. If you say what he has said, miracle will come upon your life. If you say what God has said, you must say, so that salvation will come. And healing will come. And deliverance will come. And power will come. And the promise of God will be fulfilled in your life. I rejoice with you tonight. Are you still there? I said I rejoice with you tonight. Look at the prayer. Because this prayer, so it's going to be fulfilled according to the promise of God. Jeremiah chapter 17. I'm reading from verse 14. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 14. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. You see, it tells us how to pray. It says, you don't need to do read my role. Go here, go there, go there, bend there. It says, say it simple. You say, I'm the sick one. I'm the one having a problem. I'm the one having a time. I'm the one that is poor. I'm the one that needs your help. I'm the one that needs deliverance. I'm the one that needs healing. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Look at the next thing there. Save me, and I shall be saved. Save me. That's a prayer you can pray to God. No other person can save you. This man has realized the problem. Now he got the promise. He said, I come with the promise in the presence of God. And I say, nothing in my hand I bring. But my tears forever flow. But my seal no respite no. All means for sin cannot atone. And I sacrifice wrath. And I sacrifice pots of oil. And I burn candles. And I go to River Jordan. And I give money to the priest. It says nothing in my hand I bring. Simply to the cross I cling. Because I look at the Lamb of God. Lamb of God. Sacrifice for me. Lamb of God. That died for me. Save me.
Damila.
And I shall be saved. Salvation is available tonight. Promise of salvation for your soul. Why is it that he can save you? That you don't have to bring a sacrifice. You don't have to bring any money. You don't have to bring anything. Jeremiah tells us in chapter 23. And it is in verse 6. Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 6.
In his
days, Judah shall be saved. In the days of Christ, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. Because Christ has come. In his day, Judah shall be saved, and Israel shall dwell safely.
Israel,
this is his name, whereby he shall be called the Lord our righteousness. The Lord our righteousness. He said, you come to the Lord. He said, I'm not righteous. I'm a sinner. I'm dirty. I'm defiled. But Jesus has come for me.
He's
a righteous Savior. And he's my righteousness. I give my sin to him. He gives me his righteousness. And I can say now, is the Lord our righteousness. The Lord our righteousness. The promise of the Lord is, whosoever comes, whosoever comes, coming out of problems, whosoever comes, coming out of darkness, whosoever comes, coming out of the degradation of the shame, whosoever comes unto me, I will in no wise cast off. That's why, as we are coming today, salvation is waiting for you. Forgiveness is waiting for you. Cleansing is waiting for you. Because that's what he said he will do. But you must do something. You must make up your mind. And you must decide. I come out. And when you come out, problems of sin and sickness and suffering over. Tonight I see you free. Tonight I see you saved. Tonight I see you coming out of that evil thing. And as you come out, problems gone.
Wala your law.
Sin gone.
I saw your law.
Condemnation gone.
Idalebi your law.
Look at Jeremiah chapter 51.